Hey you guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel, Peterisms, where I tell stories of my life and just little things that I've learned as I have grown into the person that I am today. And do you ever get so excited about something that you like just are like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Something happened to me the other day, and I didn't expect it to happen. It kind of came out of nowhere, and one piece after another fell into place. And it's a very small thing that happened. Well, to me, it was a very small thing. But now on a bigger level, it's like, oh my God, somebody gets it, you know? So let me tell you what happened, okay? Y'all know that I have a BookTube channel and I talk on there a lot about books. And a lot of people have their friends who are writers send me books. I also have a lot of independent writers just reach out to me and they send me their books and they ask me to like hold it up in a video or do a review or something like that. And I get so many books that I can't possibly read all of them. But every once in a while, I'll pick up a book. If the story seems, you know, very interesting to me, or if the cover or something, I mean, like I'm easily pulled into it, then I typically kind of pick it up and I go to the front porch and I like just, you know, drink a cup of coffee and I'll read a couple pages. Well, this happened the other night. I got home late and I was uploading my vlog onto my, rendering it onto the computer, and I was kind of waiting for it to be done so I could upload it to YouTube overnight while I slept. So I had like a half an hour that I had to wait, and I grabbed this book that was sent to me and I went out onto the front porch. There have been moments in my life that I can remember specifically where I was and what was happening to me at that moment that really profoundly impacted the way that I looked at the world from that point going on. And I've talked about several of them on here. You know, there's big moment issues or big issue moments like when my mom passed away or when I got sober. I can remember those moments, specific moments of that, you know, going into treatment or, you know, the second that my mom passed away or the breakup with my ex and, you know, all kinds of things, good things and bad things. I've had a lot of positive things that have happened to me too, you know? I can remember, you know, like celebrating my 1 year sober and what a big deal that was to me because I had made it through, you know, an entire year, every holiday, every day, every season, everything sober. And that was a really big deal to me, you know? So I've had a lot of moments that were fantastic too that profoundly affected me. And I would say this was one of those moments. So let me tell you what happened. I have a viewer out there, Jessica. Hey, Jessica, how are you? Jessica, I think her name is Jessica Wildflower on all of her social media. And she has a friend whose name is Martin Alberto Gonzalez. And Martin has written a book, and it is called 21 Miles of Scenic Beauty and then Oxnard. And I'm probably mispronouncing the name of the city, but it's Oxnard, I think it's Oxnard, California. And it's close to Malibu. And this book, okay, I've literally read like 75% of this book in a setting and a half. It is so, so fantastic, so respectful of diverse populations. It's just so well thought out. But at the same time, like a lot of what he does in there, you know, if you read a lot of, I would say, intellectual, analytic, you know, material, you realize what he's doing to be respectful of diverse populations. But at the same time, his own voice, which is so important, comes through. And it's just like you're sitting there when he's telling these stories, like he's literally sitting on my couch telling me a story. And it's so fantastic, right? And not only is the book absolutely beautiful, okay? I mean, it's so cool. And there he is on the back. And he sent me this great bookmark with this little string, a twine on it, which I love. And it has the cover on it, and he signed it. And on the back of here, it has all of his social media, which some of it I'll put below. And I will also link the book where you can go find it. And then he also sent me, and I'm not doing this as any kind of shout out, okay? I get sent so many books. If you guys had any idea how many books I get sent, there's no way I could talk about all of them, and definitely not on this channel. There is a very specific reason why I am talking about this on this channel. And he sent me these stickers, okay? And then he also sent me this sticker, which is a boxing glove. And it's called, it says Box Nerd. Because Box Nerd is, what do you call it? A nickname for Oxnard, where he grew up. Now you might ask, well, why is that important? Why do you specifically hold up this one, right? This boxing glove. And let me tell you, a lot of famous boxers have come from this area. He talks about that in there. And if you read this, you would think, oh, Peter, this is interesting because this isn't something that you would typically find interesting. He's very masculine, you know, but his story is just so, so intriguing to me. But it's really about his voice. You know, his voice in the book is so pure and so genuine. There's a chapter in here where he's talking about he and his girlfriend, and they go to the beach, and she is like taking all of these classes in college, and so she's starting to think differently, and she just can't back away. It reminded me of the moment in Thelma and Louise when Thelma says to Louise, are you wanting to go forward or do you want to go home? And she says, because I can't, I've come too far, I can't go back. And it felt like that when I was reading the book, like this girlfriend of his, and you find out more later, but like, she's like, I've seen it this way, you know, I've been informed, I've been educated, and I can't see it another way. And I think that we've all had moments like that in our lives, right? Where we see something in a certain way and we can no longer not see it that way, if that makes sense. When you see a truth about somebody or a way that something happens and you can no longer ignore it. And that is why I think that it is so important that people tell their stories. And that is why I think it is so important that we pay attention to everyone's story, not just one. And you know, I started this channel, or I'm starting it August 1st. This is crazy to me, you guys. It has like 1,300 subscribers and there is nothing on over there. It's called The Storytellers. It's linked below. And if you want to tell a story, if you have a story about something that profoundly affected you in your life or something that you think that you want to share with the world because it will help them or teach them something or something that you've learned by making a mistake or whatever, please email me over there and I will get back to you. I'm currently figuring out how I want to do all this. And I've also been reaching out to several people to see if they are willing to tell a story on there. Martin is one person that I reached out to. I'm going to get emotional. I have to have a story on my channel. Jessica also asked if she can tell a story, and I haven't responded to her. So yes, Jessica, I would love to hear your story on there. It is not often in my life that I feel like people are speaking the words that are in my head that really get me, that really understand me. When I started BookTube, and this is not my BookTube channel, but when I started BookTube, you know, 2 years ago, I felt like I had found a community of people that spoke my language. They loved books, and I still feel that way, and I feel like I'm so honored to be on BookTube and be part of that community. When I find somebody that speaks and thinks a way similar to how I feel, it is reassurance that the world is still working and that there are some good things out there, good people that I can still rest assured exist in this world that sometimes we feel like it's going to, you know, hell in a handbasket. I've talked a lot in here about the importance of telling your story, and I've referenced a lot Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie that wrote the book Americana, and she did a TED Talks called The Danger of a Single Story. He speaks similarly in this book about the danger of a single story. He has a chapter in here titled Simply Box Nerd. And one of the things that I love about this book is that the chapters are very, very short, and the stories and the meanings to the stories are woven through the words that he tells. They are so profound, so prolific. When you read these stories, they're very, very small. One of the stories that I love is he talks about exaggerating, and that as storytellers, a lot of times we exaggerate. And the story is called, I need my husband here because he speaks Spanish fluently, but mucha crema a la tacos. And it, apparently that translates into like, don't exaggerate. Don't put too much cream on your taco, okay? Like, stop exaggerating. And so anyway, in this chapter called Box Nerd, he talks in here about how a lot of boxing comes out of there, and it's something that they grow up in. And he talks in here about famous boxers that came from that area. Fernando Vargas, Brandon Bam Bam Rios, Mikey Garcia, Victor Ortiz. Isn't he the one that's married to Jenna Jameson? And Hugo the Boss Centeno Jr. And I horribly mispronounce those names, I know. And he talks about boxing clubs in there. And he goes in here and he talks about the importance of learning about the counter punch. And I'm reading this and I'm like, why is he telling this? Why is he explaining in detail the importance of the counterpunch? Why do we need to know that? For a long time, he is talking about stories in his area and that all the stories that he heard were negative about the people that he grew up with in an area that he grew up in. For a long time, I accepted all stories told about my Oxnard community and me as common, taken for granted knowledge and truth. In recent years, though, I realized that almost all of the stories told about my community, my family, and me are told in a bad light with very little validity. Everything about my community and me, how we dressed, looked, and talked, was negative and had to be corrected. The stories I heard growing up told only one side of the story and were neither critical nor fully analytical. In turn, I realized the need to construct more stories, our own voices, to help debunk false images and ensure that an alternative depiction is portrayed and distributed. The stories in this book are examples of counterpunches as counter-stories. However, it is important to note that counter-stories come in all shapes and forms: films, poetry, theater, dance, drawings, books, oral stories, and more. We need stories in which we actually have a say in how we want to be presented and represented. Stories that give people, especially those who believe in everything they read and see, a true sense of those perspectives rarely told through a first-hand experience. These stories we tell are very important because they will serve as valuable tools to deconstruct negative and false portrayals presented in dominant stories about our community. Rather, they will allow us to construct and establish empowering stories that make you feel good about who you are and where you come from. In this way, I, like many others, aware of the damaging stories told about us, will keep swinging by telling stories of my own in hopes that I continue to land counterpunches. Goosebumps. Ooh, goosebumps. That is so beautiful to me. Oh my God, he gets it. You know, he gets the importance of telling stories. That was such a weird moment for me on there, but it's so important that we understand that. And no matter what your community is, okay, no matter if we're talking about, you know, the recovery community or the Latino community or the LGBTQIA plus community, or if we're talking about, you know, whatever community we're talking about, your own community of society, like he's talking about in here, if he's talking about race, or it doesn't matter, or age, or, you know, whatever community you're talking about, it is important that we all tell stories. And that we show different sides of our story, because the danger of a single story is that people will only believe that story. And until we start showing different stories, counterpunches to the truth that is already out there, people will believe what they are fed. He should be so proud of this book. This book is so powerful, and to move a man like me at 4 o'clock in the morning out on my front porch to tears is phenomenal. I'm gonna link all the information below. I want it to inspire you to find your story and reach out to me and email me and say, I want my story on video. A lot of people have asked me, would I read their story and do a video for them? And yes, I absolutely would do that. I think I will dedicate one video a week to reading somebody's story, because I want your stories to get out there, even if you're afraid to be on camera. Go and give him a little love on his Instagram or whatever. I'll link it below. And go check out his book. I will link it as well. And Martin, I just want to thank you so much for sending me this book. It is absolutely amazing. And Jessica, thank you for introducing me to this fine man. I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.